What is up? What is up, everybody? Happy Sunday and welcome to the Sunday Sip.
You're so vibrant today.
Oh, the music had me moving.
Yeah, man. I was in a little zone myself. Okay, so welcome to the Sunday Sip. You already said all of that.
Yep.
I'm Addy.
I'm Terry.
How are you guys doing today?
What's up, everybody, man? Glad to be back in the building. Glad to be back in the building with all the beautiful sippers today.
All the sippers.
Yeah, man. So, how was your week?
Weekend going great. We're doing good in the household. No migraines, thank God. Knock on something wooden. So, hopefully we stay healthy with no pain. Yay. But the weather has been crazy this week. One day it was like torrential downpour for like 2-3 days, and then it went to bright sunny skies. So yeah, we almost sipped outside today, but he didn't set anything outside.
It's a lot of stuff to have to move around.
We're at the bottom. So how is everybody out there in sipper world? Let us know what you are doing and what you are sipping on. And if you are new here, welcome, welcome, welcome. And make sure that you are putting a Q colon or the word question before your question in the comments if you have a question. And if we don't know it, the answer, maybe one of our sippers will. Also, if you are here from your vacation, or you are here as one of the crew members on one of the wonderful ships out there in the world, welcome and thank you.
Yeah, I was wondering what was going on. It's like she forgot the whole opening.
I didn't forget. I was just...
You awake? You need a cocktail already, I can tell.
Already?
Yeah, I can...
I know, I'm awake. You just threw me off by asking me how my week was.
Because I was waiting on you to get into it, man.
That's not saying do the homework.
All right, man. Shout out to a couple of people on here. Taryn Anderson. Shout out to Gina's World. Check it in. Pamela Tuttle. What's going on? Glad to have you up in here.
Oh, my God.
She's starting early. She's got that ice cold Chardonnay on the balcony. Shout out to Desiree in the house. Carla G. What's going on? I see Sydney in the house. And yes, before we continue, happy Psalm Sunday. And I'm going to go ahead and hit reset real quick.
Palm Sunday.
Palm Psalm. P-S-A-L-M.
I ain't never heard Psalm Sunday. It's Palm Sunday with the palms.
I'm Jewish now, remember? All right, so, man, let's start. You know what? We're going to come back and start the show again.
No, we're fine. I've just never heard it called Psalm Sunday.
All right, we can edit this out. Welcome to the Sunday Sip, where it is Sunday.
And we sip.
I go by the name of Terry.
I'm Addy.
And we do a little bit of this and a little bit of that. We talk about cruising. We talk about what's going on in life. And we just have a good time up in here. As you can tell, it's going to be one of those Sundays. So we probably won't be on long.
I'm perfectly fine.
I don't know, man. It's like you just...
Never heard Psalms. Psalms is the book of poems. I've never heard it called Psalm Sunday before.
All right, so let's go ahead and get it started. You know, is it Psalm Sunday? Is it Palm Sunday?
It's Palm Sunday.
If you're from the hood,
it ain't no
Palm Sunday.
It's Palm Sunday because they laid palms for Jesus as he walked. Ain't nobody lay no psalms. Ain't nobody out there quoting poems while he was walking by.
I actually did that on purpose when I was sitting outside. I was like, ooh. It's Palm Sunday.
Yes.
What if I start the show by saying Psalm
Sunday?
Saying
it wrong to throw Addy off.
So did that get you engaged? I'm pretty sure that got everybody engaged.
It threw me off.
Yeah.
That's
all 123 people. I don't know if it was more than that before then, but they are now engaged.
They are
sitting at home right now saying, what are Terry talking about?
In the world?
Psalm Sunday. It's Palm Sunday. Boy, you need help.
Thank you. Everybody is Palm Sunday. See, deaf Palm Sunday everywhere. What are you talking about?
Amen. My job is done.
Thank you.
My job is done.
He's trying to keep us on our toes.
I was getting everything
making
going
sure
on.
That we are paying attention to the craziness.
What's up, Allison Porter? Welcome from over in our family's chat life with us. Glad to have you up in here. Also, Deshaun Prater, what's going on?
Hey.
Rahima Bent says, where are you guys? We're at the house doing the Sunday
we're
sip.
In our kitchen at the bar.
In the beautiful state of Georgia.
Georgia.
Carla G says, Addy, what does your shirt say?
Somewhere between Proverbs 31 which is speaking about a fabulous wife and phenomenal woman, and Tupac. There's me.
Thus, violence was chosen as we came on the show.
Cheryl, at least Merrill, I know the right way to say a Palm Sunday.
I know what to say.
Okay.
Macrina Holder, what's going on?
Hi, shout out to the everybody.
Lou McMillan in the house, what's going on?
Hey,
happy
Lou.
Sunday, Deshaun. Looking for those doorbell announcements. See, look at there. Okay. What's up, Harry? Not time to go to the bar. Harry ready to go in already. Shout out to Larry Watts. Good afternoon. seeing you as well. Claude Sittner coming in from Baltimore. What
oh,
is
wow.
up? I got to get some stuff moved around. We got.
Are you not?
My screens are like.
Somebody said the Book of Poems.
The Book of Poems.
It's Palm Sunday and songs.
Welcome, Claude. Yes. All right. I think we can resume.
Proverbs 31 is about what a good wife
I
does.
Sure hope it is, because you know they're gonna come at
and
you if it
no,
is.
No, see, I know that.
I'm just saying.
It's what a good wife is, and so this harks back to my bouginess and hoodness, somewhere between the role of a good wife and Tupac. There's me, so I'm on a fine line. There, so I saw the T-shirt and I had to get it.
It's gonna be one of them hat to the back days. I can tell you already now.
Hat to the back, gotta wear my pistol.
I knew you were gonna do that.
That's the kind.
All right,
of
man.
Shout out to TLC.
You got me thrown off, man. Every day, every Sunday, it's a different thing. All right, so if you do have a question, like Addy said, it's Q colon down in the chat below, or simply just type out your question and we'll get to them. We'll kind of throw them off to the side. A lot of stuff happened this week in the cruising world.
Oh, my God.
We're going to talk about it, from canceled sailings to new ships to old ships trying to put in their 2 weeks.
Resignations.
Their 2 week, resignation. We'll talk about all that.
My God.
But we got a question that'll get you started, coming in from Allison Porter Hot. Does the gratuity price go up once you're on the ship if you don't prepay?
No. Gratuities do not go up in price. Gratuities are actually just one flat fee, but it depends on the cruise line, and it also depends on if you are a regular cabin or a suite. Usually suite cabins have a higher gratuity. But gratuity is the same whether you prepay or pay on the ship. Most people just like to prepay so that they don't have to worry about paying something at the end of their cruise. So that's kind of what we do. Never skip out on paying your gratuities. Never, never, never do that. But we just like to prepay ours so we don't have to worry about it at the end of the cruise. But yeah, prices do not change.
Yeah, I'm kind of at that point now where before we would just let it ride, but now I kind of like to go ahead and just knock out
all the bills.
Get on the ship and get off the ship.
Yeah.
Like the cruise lines that do that and have the included gratuities, like Virgin, I think that's a great thing, mm-hmm. Because you get there, you're having a ball, you forgot all about the gratuity things.
You ain't got to worry about paying.
You got
nothing.
One or two things going on. You're either going to get a text message, and you're like, what are all these charges doing going
world?
To my car? And then you're going to get mad, you're going to be upset, you're going to get out your vibe, you're going to be all over the cruise line. So, yeah, just go ahead and...
like to prepay.
Prepay those gratuities.
That way you know if you do have a bill at the end of the cruise, it's because you've bought something or paid for something or did some kind of service.
Shout out to Elaine coming in hot. Thank you
Thank you, Cruise Auntie.
Your super chat.
She said, happy wife, happy life.
Oh, well. I got to get me one of them then so I can have all that.
Dropping dollars for you, Auntie Cruise.
Oh, man. Lafina says Palm Sunday. Catherine says definitely Palm
definitely
Sunday
palm.
Everywhere. Okay. I had y'all. I was testing y'all.
Psalm Sunday.
Make sure y'all was good. All right. So a lot of that. Let's see here.
I have a question.
Yeah. What's up?
Is our cocktail Easter themed, or are you doing an Easter themed cocktail next week? Are we sipping next week?
For Easter?
That was like four questions. That was like four questions all in one question. So is it just a regular?
Yeah, we'll let the sippers decide, but probably with everybody doing family stuff.
Yeah, we don't usually sip.
And going to church for the first time in this year. And till this time this'll next year.
This will be the second time, because some people go for New Year's.
Oh, well, yeah.
Some people go for New Year's. And
let me keep going, because I'm going to get in trouble. I think it's that
pollen. Hi, Harold.
The pollen is pollinating. That's probably what's wrong with me. I'm just all over the place today.
Hi, Harold.
Let's see. Davia says, happy Palm Sunday, everybody. Happy to see you.
Hi. And
thank you for the Hideaway Beach video. It was lit.
It is so lit.
I love you guys. You are so cool and humble. Aww. God bless y'all.
Thank you. We bless you, too.
Thank you there, Davia.
Thank you.
Welcome to the sip. Natalie White says, hi, Addy and Terry. Kevin and I are in Sarasota heading to the beach to sip and watch the sunset.
Oh, no. Nice.
That's what I'm talking about, man.
I want to go to the beach.
Yeah, man.
Sip.
Yeah, in the car sunset. Outside.
Mm-hmm. Let's go beach. We ain't got no beach.
I tell you what. I'm going to go to Lowe's, get a whole lot of sand, sprinkle it in one little area. We'll blow up the little floaties, and I'll get a kid pool so you can put your toes in there, and then boom. We at the beach, because that's about as fast as we're going to get there.
By the time you do all that, we could drive.
So. But could we really?
3-4 hours, yeah.
All right, Sugar says that she prepays her gratuity. It's less stress.
Exactly.
Gina says she loves that about Virgin. Good to know. Let's see, we prepay and then take cash to tip. Yes.
Same.
Candace says, hey, Sip fam, currently at work, stopping in. Happy Palm Sunday.
Hey, don't get in trouble at work.
A couple of people agreeing with you on the Proverbs. And just like that. So while we're waiting on people to engage on this day, you know, we're going to go ahead and
we're chilling today.
We're going to go ahead and get into some news. So
you going to hit with the first one?
No, I'm not going
there. Are you saving that one?
I'm saving it.
Man, it's so funny,
I'm saving it, man. So, everybody's getting into, or I'm not saying, the private cruise island game.
Oh, yeah.
We've had some big, major announcements coming out. The Carnival Camp for some stuff that they're getting ready to do on their private island.
Yes.
There's still stuff that's going to be happening in the Dominican Republic that kind of was news about a year or so ago, then it's been kind of quiet, but I think they're still working on it because there are two more ports in the Dominican that are going to start receiving cruise ships soon. So as soon as we get that information, we'll share that.
Absolutely.
But one of the big things out the Royal Caribbean camp this week was the fact that they are going to do a new beach club in Cozumel.
That's so exciting. I love it.
That's why you did the burr, burr, burr.
Yes, that's exciting. That was the announcement. Burr, burr, burr.
Oh, I should have hit the little button.
Yeah. I would if you would give me a button.
For those that don't know, Royal Caribbean did announce a new beach club. It is going to be the new Royal Beach Club on Cozumel, opening in 2026. Now, what they're saying about this one, of course, everybody knows Cozumel's very fun port, one of our favorites.
Love Cozumel.
But so many ships have been going there for so long, they're running out of things to do.
Like, that's kind of true.
Yeah.
That is kind of true.
So from what it looks like, they're going to be doing it on the western coast of the island in Quintana Roo, which is home to the city of Cancun, dubbed Royal Beach Club Cozumel. It's going to be a luxury destination, including a variety of amenities and activities. I guess they're going to have like swim-up bars, private cabanas, snorkeling, kayaking, a street market, hands-on experiences like tequila tastings and cooking classes and stuff. So it's not going to be a perfect day. It's going to be a luxurious perfect day.
A luxury cocoa.
A luxury cocoa K and Hideaway.
Okay. Okay. Yeah,
this is all coming out of Michael Bailey. They had a couple of renders, but not too much.
Those look pretty.
But what they're saying is you're going to be able to, what did they say? I had that up there. It's going to be about 17 acres.
Mm-hmm.
Lots of hangouts, lots of swimming pools, lots of activities catered to adults and family. But you'll be able to lean more into the Mexican culture. With the beach club, there'll be restaurants, bars, lounges inspired by the local culture and the cuisine. So that's going to be pretty interesting. And once it opens in 2026, I think it's going to be one of those must-go-to destinations. And for everybody that's kind of starting to feel Cozumel like Nassau, it'll give you another reason to do one of those Cozumel cruises.
I wanted to... Okay, that I just read my answer. I was like, are they going to dock at Cozumel and then you have to go to this new beach club? Or is it going to dock right there? Do you know? But I just read, I think I just read that it was going to, you still dock at the same place and then go. That would be cool, though.
Yeah, I think that'd be pretty dope. What do you guys think about that? Are you down for a new beach club? I told y'all, they're trying to go after these all-inclusive hotels. Yeah. Whether they're going to do it on the ship or they're going to do it at land, they're going to make sure they get your dollar. Let them know in the comments below what you think about that. Are you excited for more beach clubs and more big ships with things to do? Or are you still team, put me on the land and let me do my thing?
I think that sounds very fun. I think it'll be very interesting to see how they make it. One, to make it Mexico, because right now all of them are either Dominican Republic or Nassau, or not Nassau, but Bahamas. So to tie in a Mexican beach club would be really cool. Mm-hmm. And two, to have it be more laid back and chill, like a more grown up, like you said, luxury Coco. So you don't have the water slides and you don't have like all the water park thing going on, but to have that laid back chill vibe going on, I think that would be epic.
Claude Sittner III comes in with a question. He says, what's that the best way to get a good rate for Southwest Airlines in September?
Alerts.
Yeah.
There's no way to get a bet. I mean, the only way to get good airline flight or good prices for airlines is to do an alert.
Yeah. I mean, and it may or may not help, but try using the incognito mode in your browser because what happens when you just go and you browse and you search for a couple of times, it's going to start noticing that your IP address is the same and it's going to either start bumping the price up. So if you want to get a clean kind of rate or search, go into incognito mode, and that should help out a little bit as well. But yeah, just set an alert and just keep looking out. Just know, I think once people start planning their vacations, they start realizing what times of the year are busiest. Some ports, airports are going to be more expensive in certain places. Like, it is ridiculous for us to get from here to like Colorado, and you would think coming out of the
right,
you'd be able to get there, but it's ridiculous. So
yeah, right.
Hope that helped out. Brother Mallard said, "Hey, Addy and Terry, a little late celebrating my mom's 80th birthday.
Happy birthday, mom!"
Let's see. Crystal B says, "Carnival sent her an offer for an $80 cruise." I was like, "Yay!" Then I saw it was on the Freedom, and what a perfect way to segue. If you did not know, on yesterday when we got the word from
some
of the cool kids, they were like, "Yo, it's happening again." And I'm like, "Looking."
Again.
And I'm like, "Wait a minute. Another funnel's on fire?" And then as we got deeper into the conversation, we were like, "Wait a minute.
What ship is that?
Is that the Freedom?"
She just got fixed.
So we have come to the conclusion that basically at this point, the Freedom is basically saying, can I put in my 2 weeks? I'm tired, boss.
I'm tired.
I don't want to cruise no more. I can't carry no more people.
I's done.
And I think they're saying that a lightning strike hit it. Yes. So the thing with the funnel is it's really there for show.
Yes.
The main part of the stack is right in the center. That's why you see most of the ships, they'll have their stacks right in the center. The whale tail is basically show. It just takes that air from here.
Yes.
And then funnels it out.
Yes.
That way. Or at least that's what they're telling us. So hopefully, if you were on that cruise, everything is A-OK. Good to go. You're safe. If you got a cruise coming up after this one docks, it's showtime. Nothing changes. You're still going to be able to go out and have a good time. So
you just won't have a pretty ship. Cosmetics will be applied.
Yeah, man.
Oh, I'm sure Carnival is going to reimburse most of the people that were on board and affected by it.
I don't think they are at all.
No, they did for the first fire, too.
Have you heard anything about this one?
I mean, it just happened yesterday, so I'm quite sure that they will get some kind of compensation.
They're going to get like $50.
No. No, I mean, when Carnival.
But think about all the people that's got like the $5 and $10 cruises. Like, are you really going to be upset and want compensation? And
yes, pay they $5 will. $10? You know the calls I used to get. They don't care if they was on the ship for free. I want compensation.
Let's see. Let me look. Let me see if that's. Let's see what Carnival's saying.
Compensation. But I'm sure that they will get compensated. If not, because I know last time, because the fire was an actual ship-related issue. And so I know that last time they got that cruise for free. They got reimbursed for the cruise, and then they got another cruise out of it. So I don't know if they're going to do that again, but I'm pretty sure that they will get some kind of compensation for it.
I'm just not going on that ship. I told y'all about them old ships. Mm-mm.
But the Freedom isn't that old.
Amen. It's old enough. So, yeah, I'm not seeing anything from Carnival saying anything about next steps, basically.
It does say that.
And the fact that the next cruise is, they're already back out.
Yeah. It's like, they didn't.
They just got some duct tape on that bad boy. So.
Some spray paint real quick.
Right. Catherine comes in with a question. She says, Royal Beach Club, will it be more like Mr. Sancho's or Paradise Beach vibes?
I'm leaning towards Paradise Beach more than Mr. Sancho's, because Mr. Sancho's does give you more of the rowdy vibe, whereas Paradise Beach is more chill.
Yeah, I think we can expect that.
Yeah.
Shout out to Biggity Bankston, my Cozumel homie.
We need to go back.
Sugar says, I bet you that beach club is not going to be free. They gonna gouge, LOL.
I mean, it's Royal. So they're probably going to charge. If they're going to do the way that I think they're going to do, they'll probably do it the way they did Hideaway Beach at Coco Cay.
I don't know.
Where it's, you do have to pay extra, but it probably isn't going to be outrageously extra. Hmm. Because it is for families.
Hmm. Mm-hmm.
We'll just have to see. We'll have to see what 2026? That's when it comes out.
2026. So yeah. They're obviously already working on it. Or have been working on it.
Or getting ready to start working on it.
You know, what if a cruise line and went and bought like an actual resort and converted it?
But why?
Like if there's a
like, but why?
And then they take all of their amenities. I don't know. I'm just saying,
that could be Margaritaville something. Did the opposite. They had the resorts. Now they stepping into the cruise world.
What's up, Mr. Jonesy? Trina says she can't wait to try Virgin's Bimini. I think you'll enjoy it.
Bimini is its own vibe.
Candace Harris says, I thought you were saying Nude Beach Club, but that's awesome. I usually would go to Mrs. Sancho's in Cozumel. Elaine says she'd be down because a lot of the cruises go to Cozumel.
Yes. We love Cozumel.
Let's see. Sydney says, both work, one own thing or beach club. Experience everything.
Yeah.
Yeah. Shout out to LaShonda checking in. What's going on? Miss Jonesy says she's excited for the beach clubs. Sugar says, I always love Cozumel. I want the money to go to the local people.
Okay, so here's my question for you guys. For you all that like going to the beach clubs that are in destinations like the Mr. Sancho's and the Day Pass Resorts, things like that, when you are in port, do you like to do stuff like that? Or do you like to do like an actual excursion? Do you like to go out and do something specific in the town, or do you like to go and chill at the beach? That's a curiosity that just popped in my head. Mm-hmm. Which do you prefer? Which one do you like? Do you like when we go and do an actual excursion, or do you like to go and chill at a beach club?
I'm a beach club person.
I think you've morphed into a beach club
person. I'm a beach club
person. You used to be the excursion.
Because everything was exciting and new then.
You used to be an excursion guy. But now,
you can only swim with dolphins and touch manta rays and hike and do, yeah, until you're
I
just kind of like
for the excursion.
Like, yeah, you know,
I'm all for the excursion.
Shout out to your moms in the chat saying,
Hi,
Happy
Mom.
Palm Sunday, sitting here reminiscing on our Sundays with the palm branches.
Yes, what's up did to your the church sippers? Do that?
Just depend. Trina says, I love a cruise, so bring on the beach clubs.
Got you. I'm yeah. for it, too.
Let's see. Cheryl says they need to fireproof those funnels.
But you, know, you would think they are.
But the fact that it's the same ship.
Something.
Somebody gosh. Done did something or something God on the ship. To tell let's see. Carla says beach clubs are pretty good. The beach club at Bimini was great, so I'm all for it.
Yes.
Crystal B says, for real.
Right.
Easy Sailing says, agree. Cruise companies have enough money, will default to supporting local people.
That's also one of the reasons why I like excursions.
Yeah. Well, I mean.
But we like to. We also like to find beach clubs that are local.
Yeah.
So we do the best of. So we do the best of both worlds, kind of. So.
Yeah, a little bit. Let's see here. Oh My Day says, hey, yeah, I'm new to your channel. Will Royal Caribbean's Cozumel Beach Club replace their Labadi Club? Or is it in addition to, I know, they're taking a break from that location for a month or so. And welcome to the welcome. Sunday Sip. Oh, My Days. That's a good question. You want
to
take it?
I believe that it will be in addition to. I don't think that they are getting rid of Labadi at all. I think that they are just going to give Labadi a break because of the situations going on in Haiti right now. Or did I say it wrong?
Yeah, I don't really think that's going to have anything to do with yeah. Labadi. I think Labadi is still going to do its
Labadi
thing.
Labadi is still going to be Labadi.
It's a completely different part
yeah,
of it's the Caribbean.
Yeah, it's actually yeah. just a little, it's not an actual like beach club or anything. It's just a section of beach in Haiti that is sectioned off. And you actually can't really go into Haiti from Labadi. It's like all cordoned off and everything. But I think they're just taking a break because some cruisers are a bit nervous about going there when there's all the unruliness going on over there.
Well, I mean, right now, yeah.
Makes so, sense. But yeah, I think it will be in addition to, not a replacement.
HBCU band talk in the house. That's good. Says Carnival Sunrise had a flood.
Right.
Was that in your? Oh, I didn't yeah. hear about that.
It got flooded. That was not the one that we went on, but yeah.
Yeah. When did that happen?
Over the past couple of days.
What happened?
It got flooded.
Oh. Where was the flood? I'm asking I don't know
everything.
Like
I don't know everything. I just remember seeing that headline.
Teresa T says, I'm on the April 4th sailing, and they just canceled the March 25th and 30th.
Oh, wow. Oh. Well, for the Freedom?
Maybe they are. Like, well, I mean, you wouldn't.
I'm sure they got to do checks to make sure.
I mean, you don't really want to be sailing around. It's bad enough you got rust on the outside and you're not painting over it, but you pretty much don't want to have a charred whale
yeah,
tail.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I'm pretty sure they're going to go in and remove all the charred.
They're
going to
take it apart again, and it's just, they should just leave that funnel smack dab in the middle on that ship. Don't even put the whale tail back on it.
I mean, but it looks weird. Remember when we weren't saw it in port before it got
like,
fixed?
Just like Costa, just have that one unique ship that just had, don't put the whale tail back on it.
I think they should decommission
it. It wants to be free. Mel on the Move says, hello, fam. Finally made it to another sip. Welcome. Karen is in the house.
Hello.
Let's see. Deshaun said, I did hear about the flood on Carnival Sunrise. I'll be cruising it in May.
Have fun.
Let's see. Claude Sittner says, any updates on the Ocho Rios Jamaica dock? Nope. As far as I've heard.
Still under construction.
Still under construction. Still working on it. No date for that reopening as of right now. Mm-hmm. Carla says, question. Did you hear about Holland America?
If you're referring to the two crew members, yes. And our prayers and condolences go out to their families.
Yeah, that's always sad when something happens to anybody, you know, mm-hmm. Whether it's crew or whether it's individual people. Our prayers go out to the crew, the family members of that crew, and to everybody that, you know, is affected by that. That's mm-hmm. just...
Yeah, co-workers. Oh, my God. Can you imagine the co-workers?
And, of course, they didn't give too many details on that, but the fact that it happened in engineering, you can only kind of...
Assume the worst.
Yeah. Please. Sharon Wright says they have canceled the sailing. The letter is on John Hill's page. Okay. Thank you, Sharon, for giving us that update. Linda Kah says Carnival canceled the March 25th and 29th sailings on Freedom, and those booked will receive full refunds and FCC.
Told you.
That's what I'm talking about.
They don't
about,
play man. When Carnival gonna keep them people. Like, thank oops, you, sorry, Linda. Your ship caught fire. We're going to give you a free cruise.
Carla says, yeah, Margaritaville. We see how that's working out.
See?
Easy Sailing says, Celebration Key actually really adds to the economy because Freeport never recovered from big hurricane mm-hmm. years ago. Cozumel is fine as is.
True. I think Celebration Key, actually, I am actually really looking forward to Celebration Key because Freeport never recovered.
No.
But I think Cozumel, I think all the cruise line ports will benefit from the cruise lines.
Let's see, Sydney says, not even chill at the beach, chill at a pool close to the food, bar, and bathroom. I'm excursioned out. Gina says, depending on the destination, she can go either way.
Okay.
But she leans more towards the beach clubs.
Okay.
Aaron says, actual excursion. I want to see the culture, enjoy the local food, etc. Beach club only at one stop per cruise.
That's what we're starting to lean toward.
Yeah. It's like, once you've done a beach club one time, unless the itinerary is just whack and there's nothing else to do.
Why?
No.
But why would you pick a whack itinerary?
Well, sometimes you don't have a choice. And I'm not saying like, okay, let me rephrase that. The itinerary is not whack. But let's just say if you've already been to that destination and you've already done the stuff that's interesting to you, then you're not going to want to get out and do an excursion. You're just either going to want to stay on the ship or you want to go to a beach right. club. But if you go to, but let's say if you have multiple stops that are like that, I don't think you're going to want to go to a beach club every time you stop. There is a limit to how many beach clubs you can do.
On one cruise.
Yeah.
Like yeah,
one
absolutely.
Good beach day at a beach club is boss.
But it is.
Two, three, nah.
True. I completely agree.
Yeah. I try to find something to do then.
We used to do like one historic, especially when we were cruising with the kids. Yeah. We would do like one historic excursion, one like arts and crafty type excursion, a beach day, and then we let the kids pick something. It depended on how many ports we were going to, but we would usually let the kids pick one and then we would pick all the other ones. It's like, oh, you gonna learn something.
Lynn says, I think it depends on the destination. I like both.
Yeah.
Excursions and beach club.
Yes.
Carla says, don't forget about the pigs, Terry.
Yes, that was an excursion, but it was also a beach day.
Yeah, I mean, the pigs were kind of cool. That's different.
Yes.
That's different.
Yeah.
So there are things you can find that are different. Janelle, what's up? She says, hey, depends. Janelle. I like excursions if it's adventure excursions, but for Bimini, club is better.
Yes.
Yeah, I agree with that,
yes.
too.
Because there's not much else.
Candace says, my family usually does Mr. Sancho's, but it depends on if I see any excursions that I like in Cozumel. It's mm-hmm. usually the same type of one, so I think that's why I like beach clubs more.
And for excursions, I really think it all depends on what it is you like to do and what those places offer. Like, if you're not a water person, mm-hmm. So you don't like to do the snorkeling or the diving or anything like that. So swimming with the pigs and swimming with the dolphins is not going to be your jam.
Right.
So maybe something like something historical, like we like to go find the Mayan ruins and we like to do culture stuff like mm-hmm. with the food and the drinks and learning, like the one excursion we did where we actually went and cooked. That would be really cool.
Yeah.
So I think it really just depends on what you like to do. Because they have so many different types of excursions now, like the horseback riding and then the hiking, the jet skis.
Yeah. Let's see. Macrina Holder says, cancel it. I think this month.
Oh, more confirmations. Gotcha.
Yeah. Easy Sailing says they're dumbing down cruise travel.
They really are. And I really wish they wouldn't.
Let's see, a couple of people mentioning that.
Oh, there's the pipe.
Sunrise a pipe burst during a storm.
Macrina
says maybe Margaritaville at sea will buy the freedom. Cheryl says, Terry, is Margaritaville looking better for you? They never had a fire or a flood.
I love y'all.
Cheryl, really? That's how we get down today.
Love y'all.
But while you're playing, so I came across an interesting story when I was sitting outside earlier, and it has to do with Carnival.
Okay.
And a recent post from John Held.
Uh-oh.
So most of you know that when you're on a cruise ship, and if you're like like some people that like to watch television, or you're a big sporting person, or you like to watch movies, you notice that certain cruise lines are very limited.
Yes.
In their selection, some cruise lines have a little bit more. One person wrote to John Hill that they were wondering if a certain event was going to be aired on Carnival ships. This person, I guess, is an extreme fan of The Bachelor.
Are you serious?
And was like, I need to know if you guys are going to carry The Bachelor from ABC on the ship and put it on the big screen, because I'm sure so many of us are waiting to see how everything ends. And if we don't get a chance to see it, we're just going to be crushed. So, and John, in pure John fashion, was just kind of like, you know, I'm so sad. I really hope he finds love, but hell no.
I was about to say, I know John was like, no. Oh, no. My gosh. That is so crazy.
First off, the only cruise line that could even carry ABC would be Disney, because Disney owns ABC.
Right.
So for sporting events and things like that in Bachelor, you got to go on a Disney cruise if you want to see it. All other cruise lines are, you know,
at the mercy of...
Yeah.
The TV.
Like,
the mercy of the satellites.
Even when you're looking like for like the big sporting games, like a World Series or Super Bowl.
We didn't even get commercials.
You got to get clearances for that.
Oh, they
have to get they clearance? Can get fined. Like, if they just go and turn it on somehow, they can get fined for that. So you have to pay to carry those programs. And if you're not already getting that service on their satellite, they can be fined for that stuff. So that's when people get upset.
That's why we didn't get no commercials.
How come we don't get to see? Yeah.
That's why we didn't get a commercial.
Well, think about it. It's just like when you had to do the pay-per-view to see boxing and certain things back in the day.
Oh, so they had the cruise ships got to do pay-per-view?
Yeah. Kind of, basically.
So every single cruise line, so when we always sail during the NBA finals, and they be having the NBA games on there, they have to pay for those?
Well,
if they don't have the ESPN Caribbean or ESPN, blah, blah, blah. Yeah. Okay, got you.
But if they don't have it on board, they just can't get it on board.
Got you. I got you.
Desiree Dixon, welcome to the Sunday Sip. She says, hello, Terry and Addy. I'm new to your channel and enjoying your lives.
Have
you been on the Carnival Glory? It's an old ship. I'm going in May this year for my daughter's birthday. How is that ship?
That is one of the cruises that we have not been on. We have not been on any of that class. Mm-hmm. So we can't really tell you. I have it's in the same class as the Freedom. But it does get a lot of good reviews that I have heard. I haven't heard anything bad about the Glory. So it's just not one that we have sailed on.
Right.
That's one whole class that we haven't done. The Glory, the Magic, the Freedom, all of those ones, we haven't done that.
Yeah. I mean, I know a lot of people will always say, you just kind of do your research. Go and look and see what's going on. But, you know, I'll always say, find out what's important to you and if they have that on the ship.
Right.
If you're a person that's okay with where you stay and you don't really have to have that luxe life, you need to determine that before you get on board, because you would hate to go and, you know, you live in Motel 6 on Regent's, the Ritz Dreams, you know?
Right.
And vice versa. But just kind of look and see what's available for your kids that your kids are into, to include the excursions from the ports that you're going to go
to.
The activities that are on the ship, kind of search for reports from people to find out how the counselors that deal with kids,
the kids counselors, the kids
are with the kids, and just the things for yourself. Maybe there's certain restaurants and foods that you like in places. Just kind of do that kind of research, and I think you'll be good to go.
I can say that I do have clients booked on the Glory for October for quinceañera. So nothing bad that I have thought or that I've heard about the ship. And they actually picked that ship specifically for the itinerary. So I think you'll have a great time.
Yeah, and welcome to the sip, Desiree.
Thank you.
Teresa T. says, if they cancel the April 4th sailing, I'm thinking about booking Margaritaville at sea. It's my daughter's birthday and gotta find something to do with that PTO. Now, miraculously, I will say, most people that I see, other than content creators, that have gone on the Margaritaville, actually enjoy their cruise.
They are enjoying the Margaritaville at sea.
Yeah.
We still got to convince him to go. No, I ain't got to convince him because you did say you would do the new one.
Yeah.
not the OG.
I don't want to do the original. But
not the OG, but the new one.
No cap. It is rare that I see people complaining about
that is true. We haven't heard any complaints
that are paying to go on Margaritaville.
That is true.
Other than content creators,
we haven't heard any.
Now I'm not going to say that was how it was at the beginning. So maybe they fixed some things, cleaned some things up, and
didn't it go in dry dock?
Yeah.
So maybe like since the beginning, we haven't heard anything about it.
So you know,
maybe they cleaned up their act.
Might need to take one for the team and see what's going on over there.
I mean, we free next weekend.
Claude says, John's response was hilarious.
It's John.
Shout out to Angela. What's going on?
Hey, hey.
Let's see. He said it's too expensive to carry some networks. Linda has a question. She says, what's the best resort for a day to visit while in Nassau that includes food and beverages?
You got that one.
Well, there are plenty. But the one for us will be the Ryu. We just like the Ryu. The Ryu Nassau, the Ryu in Jamaica. You're going to get your food. You're going to get your beverages. You're going to get all your beach activities. It's a good vibe. And it's adults only. Mm-hmm. So that would be my recommendation. There are others. If you are more family oriented, there's the new Margaritaville is beach was resort.
Yes.
There's that one that has a really nice water park.
And then you've got Baja Mar.
Yeah, and then if you just really want to step up your game, mm-hmm. Baja Mar is an excellent resort.
And, of course, Atlantis.
Yeah.
But we prefer Ryu.
Yeah, if you just want to go.
For the price.
And you just want to go chill, relax, drink, have a good time.
For the price, the Ryu. Lit.
Yeah.
The Ryu will get you right.
But if you want to go do water type stuff and family.
Was that the one that did the water slide? Or was that Jamaica?
No, that was in Jamaica, the one you talked about.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
Cube Duration says, I've been on the Valor twice. I love it. The Glory is in the same class, and it sails from New Orleans and Port Canaveral.
Yes. See, that's what I was going to say. Yes. That's just the one class out of Carnival that we have not sailed.
Let's see, Linda says, I'm considering getting on the newer Margaritaville Islander. It looks more promising.
That's the one, Terry.
Linda, you're not by yourself. I'm actually...
He was like, okay.
I'm actually like, more investigation was needed, and I'm still on that.
Yeah.
Let's see. Gina says, if you look up Carnival Cruise on Wikipedia, it provides a list of their fleet with the year the ship was built or refurbished. It's helpful for planning.
Very much so. Excuse me. Very much so. Good advice, Gina.
Yeah. Let's see here. Kisa says, I usually like at least one beach club visit on my cruise. I'm booking a cigar rolling excursion on Virgin for the summer. Trying something different.
Kisa, okay,
girl,
Kisa.
That's what I'm talking about. Man, let's give me.
Which port are you going to for Virgin? Because we could probably give you some ideas if you're doing like Dominican days. We could hook you up with some people for that cruise. Dear.
Yeah, I know. I just noticed the time.
I am parched.
We've been Sundaying for the last couple of Sundays, but we've been missing out on the sip. So, yes, it is time for the sip portion of the Sunday sip. And if you are here to imbibe, we have just the thing for you. You will be able to find today's cocktail.
Did you see that? Bomas.
Oh. You'll be able to find today's cocktail on our community page on YouTube, or if you follow us on IG. Today's cocktail is called the Pineapple Train Wreck.
Oh, my God.
Because we're getting into spring and you want something kind of light and sweet and whatnot, but that's still kicks a little punch.
That's a lot of rum.
And this one's going to kick a little punch, so you'll be able to find the recipe there. I'm going to take it to the back and do what I do. If you want to follow along, you can. But with that being said, you know what time it is, eh?
To the bay!
Well, I wasn't quite ready, but.
Oh, Jesus.
You go ahead, do it again.
Okay. Ta-da!
Where one day we're going to do a real professional show.
One day we will be professional, but then that wouldn't be us.
No, right.
And we are Addy and Terry.
You know all the thingies and the
I
things.
Know the things.
And the things and the things. All right.
All right.
So, today, for your cocktail, you are going to need an aged rum. Any aged rum will do fine. I am using one with a little bit of kick. None of this is sponsored. This is Smith & Cross. It's a traditional Jamaican rum. I'm also going to use some Ray and Nephew for the extra powwow. Also an overproof Jamaica rum. You're going to need some pineapple juice, preferably fresh, but whenever you don't have fresh, this is the way to go. Also, we're going to use some ginger syrup. Now, you'll be able to find some recipes online to help you make some ginger syrup, but we have one.
We got that one from Martinique.
From Martinique when we were there. You're going to need some bitters, some Angostura, and some Peychaud's, and some fresh lemon juice. So with that, I'm going to build, and we'll be back to do this cocktail.
All righty. I appreciate y'all coming through with oh, babe, never mind. There it is. I couldn't find the mouse, y'all. I'm with it. I got it.
Okay.
All right, so Desiree is thanking everyone for that information about the glory. You are very, very welcome, Desiree. I appreciate all of y'all thinking I was funny, but I was serious. I am thirsty. Sydney says, oh, Lord, I see Ray and Nephew. You know Terry gonna always put Ray and Nephew in something. That's a lot. Is this a shaking drink or just a build?
This is shaking.
Okay. Sugar Bear. Oh, my music stopped. There we go. Says, hello, everybody. I'm going on my first all-inclusive resort for my birthday in 2 months. Jamaica Riu Montego Bay. I said Montego. Montego Bay. What can you tell me about it? Is that the one we went to?
Yep, we went to both.
That's the one we went to. You? No, I didn't go to Reggae. You went to Reggae.
Oh, yeah. That's the one.
That's the one you went. Yeah. Okay, so Montego Bay. Why do I keep saying Montego? Montego Bay, the Riu there, is awesome. It actually has a little water park. It's like 3 or 4 slides that are pretty epic. The food is great. The service is phenomenal. I think you will really enjoy yourself. The whole property itself is really, really beautiful. They don't in particular have the overwater bungalows, but you can see them because it's right next door to the Sandals in Montego Bay, and they have the overwater bungalows. So you can see them out in the water, but it's really, really beautiful. Absolutely gorgeous there. The drinks will be drinking, okay? Let me just put it that way. Service will be serving. It was great. Mile High Melanin. We haven't seen you in a minute. Welcome back, darling. She says she's sipping on a French 75. You like gin. I would like a French 75 if it didn't have gin. Angelica said, hey, boo. How you doing? Are you doing some artwork right now? She says, professional. Where's the fun in that? That's our Angelica, babe. I still gotta find a frame for your art piece so I can put it on the wall. Janelle said she's making the banana drink from a couple of weeks back.
Girl, you're gonna like it.
It was so good. You're gonna enjoy that one. Question, this is for you, Terry. I'll wait till you're done shaking. There you go. Are bitters bitter?
That is a good question. Not all bitters are bitters, are bitter, but think of bitters kind of like you think of spices when you're making
a cocktail. No, like food.
Food, yeah.
They're like spices.
Some can be aromatic. Some can have a little bitterness to them. Some can even have a little sweetness as well. It just depends on what kind of bitters you're using.
Okay. Well, there you go. Taryn is asking, show the bottle of the aged rum again. She wants to know what aged rum you're using.
One second. Got to get rid of the water in my glass.
Davia said, Ray and nephew, whoo, had me saying the alphabet backwards.
Oh, it is Smith and Cross.
Smith and Cross. There's the aged rum we're using, Taryn. So there you go. It is from Jamaica. Okay, Kisa says she's sailing the Riviera Maya itinerary July 28th. Okay. I haven't done that one yet. We're doing that one for Sisterhood at Sea. Again, all you ladies out there, or gentlemen, if you want to treat the lady in your ladies, because I know you got more than one lady in your life. Like mom, sister, cousins, them kind of ladies, not like you out there just being bad. If you got a lady in your life, come on Sisterhood at Sea with us. We're going to Cozumel / Playa del Carmen in the last week of August this year. Planning to do some epically fun stuff. So, more information on the website. Harry says, y'all ever thought about doing a Google Doc with all the recipes in it so every week you can add the next drink?
Will be going to our members.
That's what I was just about to say. Our members will be getting a PDF every month with, oh, you're using the good cherries. Can I get like four?
No.
But all of our members in our tier three will be getting a PDF every month with the cocktails that we prepare on the Sunday sip. Plus a few bonuses if we don't sip on a Sunday, like Easter or something like that. If we don't sip, we'll include a cocktail for that. No, Coco, you're not going outside. Coco is going through this thing, y'all, where he is like a toddler. I mean, technically he kind of is a toddler. Where, you know, when a kid wants to go outside, but then once they're outside, they want to come back inside. He's doing that. What in the world? Okay, it'd be different if we had a doggy door and he could just go in and out.
Just like that, the pineapple train wreck.
Oh, you sure I can't get one more cherry? Huh. One more cherry, please. I'm going to pout. Mile High Melanin said, putting in crazy OT for a virgin trip. I hear you, boo. All right. Teresa said, I was being cute and ordered an old-fashioned at Alchemy, and it was horrible. Oh, no. I had to send it back. My daughter asked, why did I order it? And I said, because Terry drinks old-fashions. Oh.
Well, see, there is a...
Oh, you poor thing.
There's a method to the madness when it comes to old fashions. It depends. So,
what in the world?
My bad. I was trying to get us back on.
There we go.
Here we go.
Oh, yeah, poor thing. Jesus. It was horrible.
I am so sorry. This is the part of the sip where we sip. Again, today's cocktail is the Pineapple Train Wreck.
It's very pretty.
It's aged rum, overproof rum. It is pineapple juice, fresh lemon juice, ginger syrup, Angostura, and Peychaud's bitters. It kind of looks like this.
It's so pretty.
So if you're imbibing with us, if you're sipping with us, salute, guys.
Salute. It ain't a shot. What you tapping for?
Well, I do.
Ooh. You might have needed to make more.
I'll make some later.
This is good, y'all. He's redeeming himself from that coffee and pineapple.
Y'all
drink.
I almost made another one today.
Y'all
gonna get off me with the coffee and the pineapple.
Coffee
cocktail.
And pineapple is not hitting, but all this right. Pineapple and ginger.
Where we leave off?
Pretty color cocktail.
Where?
Pretty color cocktail.
Ah, okay. Let's see. Angelica says, I am working on some custom bookmarks for my class. Glad to be on with everybody.
Oh, welcome. Oh, I'm sure they're welcome beautiful. Welcome to the Sunday Sip.
About 255 of you, and we at the moment have 148 thumbs up. That's what we call the doorbell button. So if you like the content so far, if we are just all over the place, but you're having a good time on Sunday, we'd love if you go ahead and hit that thumbs up. It just lets more people know that, you know, hey, maybe wait, go and check this out and see what it's about. We really appreciate it. And don't forget, you'll be able to find today's cocktail on our community page, on our YouTube channel as well. If you follow us on IG, you'll be able to find it there as well.
Not for very long, though, because, like I said, that's for our members.
Mario says, I enjoyed the Hideaway Bay vlog. The secret sandwich looked disappointing. So, one, I don't know if it was, it was a burger. That's the secret sandwich. And they weren't trying to hide that it what it was, but the sauce that's on the burger is what makes it
secret.
But in all honesty, it was just
they
a regular
just said
burger.
It tasted like a regular. I didn't taste it.
I mean, it was a good burger, but it was just the burger.
Yeah.
There, yeah.
Was, you and Lynette.
Now that fish sandwich.
The fish sandwich is where it's at.
That fish sandwich and the coconut shrimp.
Those are the perks of going to Hideaway Beach.
Yeah.
So you get the different menu. So you get the regular stuff that is at Coco Cay, at the regular food stations in Coco Cay. But at Hideaway Beach, they kicked it up a little bit and gave you some adult options. Like the ceviche. And the coconut shrimp.
Yeah.
And the fish sandwich.
Yeah.
And then you can get like a Caesar salad with fish or ceviche and stuff on the Caesar salad. So.
Yeah. That.
And then the pizza at Slice of Paradise.
Was actually really good.
Is really good.
Shout out to Royal on that.
So I would pay the $30, $40 just to go to Hideaway Beach just to eat.
I want to step back real quick. I go back to the old fashioned because I got
you got to redeem Miss Teresa.
Whenever my name is attached to a cocktail that you don't like, I gotta lay down some ground rules. Okay. Most people in most places you're going to go, especially if it's a restaurant, they make their old fashions a little different. First warning sign you should have if you're going for a classic old fashioned is if they bring it to you and there are red maraschino cherries, oranges, and all that stuff in your cocktail, send it back. That is not an old fashioned. If they pull out a muddler and they commence the muddling before they stop them right there.
That's not an old fashioned.
That is not a classic old fashioned. What they're making you is what's called a Wisconsin. That is a completely different cocktail. An old fashioned is basically your choice of bourbon. I prefer a rye whiskey. 100 proof is what you want.
Strong.
Not strong. It just pulls out the essence of the cocktail. You're going to want to make sure they put Demerara syrup and
bitters.
Angostura bitters. That's it. That is your old fashioned. Bourbon, bitters, sugar. If they do anything else to it, you're not getting a real old fashioned.
Y'all, I can't tell you how many
and
places.
Some people
have
done that and they're just like, ugh, this is not good. And that's the first thing I'll tell them is as soon as I see those two warning signs, I'm like,
I can't tell you how many bars we have been to, especially on cruise ships, where Terry has sent back a drink and been like, this is how you make an old fashioned.
And it's not their fault.
It's not their fault.
It's just that in the restaurant industry,
that's
normally how they teach how to make an old fashioned, not a classic
bartending school.
Old fashioned. So there is a complete difference. Not that they're doing anything wrong. It's just that if you want a true old fashioned, and especially if you're on Royal and you go to the Schooner Bar,
they will make you a
marshmallow old fashioned. I had to start making them. I have at least two or three a week now.
he's not lying. Here,
and it's literally just bourbon, marshmallow syrup, and bitters. It is amazing. With
and
a little
if you're not
orange
a fan
of
bourbon or whiskey like me, I prefer the rum old fashioned.
Mm-hmm.
Terry also likes a Oaxacan old fashioned, which is mezcal.
So perfect thing Addy is making mention. A old fashioned does not have to consist of bourbon. Mm. You can make tequila old fashions, rum old fashions, mezcal old fashions. You can make gin in old fashioned. It's just the base spirit, sugar, bitter. I mean,
a gin old fashioned? That sounds disgusting. Well, it's more like a gin,
Ricky. But all right, so let's get back to the crew stuff. That's your cocktail segment for today. I hope you guys enjoy it.
This is good. Y'all should make this one. This one is good.
Teresa T says, I learned during 2.5, I can't hang with Addy and Terry at the bar. No. Listen, your mom says, good cue about the bitters. I've been wondering the same thing.
They're seasonings.
There's actually a class I came across. I hope I didn't miss it. It's too late. Actually teach that stuff. Shout out to Anna Q. She says, hey guys, happy Sunday. I had way too much alcohol last night, so I'm sipping on key lime spring water for hydration.
Go, girl.
That's what's up. Shout out to Janelle. What's up, cuz? She says, that drink looks good. You guys are so cute. Love you too, fam.
Thank you, schmooches.
A couple of people are like, looks yummy, yum. Valencio says, yeah, you got a Wisconsin old fashioned. See, he knows.
With all the fruit.
Valencio, that's my old-fashioned brother. Valencio will get down with some old-fashioned.
Y'all gonna drink old. Y'all will drink the bartenders under the table.
Let's see. Teresa says, don't be sorry. You made up for it with the Princess Consuela banana hammock shot.
Girl, if I could remember what was in that shot, to have him make it here at home, y'all, if y'all missed it, that is the shot. If you didn't make 2.5, she's talking about the shots that were at the Apotec takeover when we were in Aruba. Mm-hmm. It was so good. It literally tasted like banana Laffy Taffys, like liquid banana Laffy Taffys. And they did 2-for-1 shots. So you bought one shot, but they gave you two.
Yeah.
It was a beautiful thing.
Let's see. Your mom says, cheers. She's still on her sangria. Terrence Simmons says, on board the Valiant Lady. Francois said, hello. What was that drink he made for you? Shout out to my man, Francois.
Hey, boo.
Yeah, man.
Hey, Sasha.
But that's just a cocktail between us.
Yes.
You know, but maybe I'll share what it was with you offline. But yeah, definitely tell Francois I said hello.
Oh, and my gosh. Hey.
Just tell him to make you something that Terry would like.
Yeah. That's if you want something bourbon-y.
No. And let him do his thing.
Let him do his thing.
Yeah.
Because he never fails us.
No. Gina's World says, question, have you guys used Club Mobay's meet and greet service offered at the Montego Bay Airport?
Yes. Actually, we have. A couple of years ago when we went to Moon Palace, we used Club Mobay when we flew into Jamaica. And it was awesome. They actually meet you right as soon as you get off the plane. They have little signs with your names on it and everything, and it really makes you feel real fancy. And then they escort you through customs so you don't have to wait in the super long line. And then you get to wait at the lounge with cocktails and snacks and food until your transport is ready to take you to wherever you are going.
Yeah.
We really enjoyed it. The departure is actually a bit better than the arrival. I'll just put that up.
I think we did a segment on that. I don't know if I still have those videos on the channel, but when we did Sandals.
Yes.
And we did
Moon Palace. Yeah.
The thing for Moon. I don't think I have that on the channel anymore, but maybe I can send it to you. You can kind of see what the experience was
very,
like.
Very, very nice.
Yeah, but we enjoyed it. I would suggest.
Yeah, the departure lounge has like massage chairs and all kinds of cool stuff in it. But yeah.
Together Excellent We service. Travel says, hello, everybody. Jersey folks says, you guys are adorable. Thank you. Right back at you. Terrence says, he's got gumbay.
Oh, my gosh.
On tap in 30 minutes.
Have fun.
If you guys don't know what we're talking about, then you got to take a Virgin Cruise. And if you've never been on a Virgin Cruise, then what a perfect segue and perfect time to let you know that we can hook you up. We are one of Virgin's top 100 advisors in North America. You see that QR code on the screen. If you have been curious about booking a Virgin Cruise, or maybe you've already sailed the Virgin Way and you want to go back again.
You should.
You've got the last couple of days on some great, great deals. If you scan that QR code, that's going to take you to the Virgin website. And if you would like to book a cruise and have us as your travel advisors, if you look in the upper left-hand corner of the screen, it will say sold and serviced by Terrence Bibb. That is going to come direct to us. Or if you have any questions prior to, you can send us an email at Addy@AddyandTerry.com or Terry@AddyandTerry.com.
That's him.
If you go to our website, you'll be able to see our upcoming sailings that are going to be on Virgin. As a matter of fact, the very next time, unless we just decide to wake up one morning and say, you know what?
Screw it. Let's go to
Virgin. Let's go to Virgin. It's going to be
Sisterhood at Sea.
Sisterhood at Sea. Addy, you want to tell them about that?
I already did.
Well, tell them again.
Okay. Sisterhood at Sea 2024 will be, you're showing you.
Oh, there we go.
Will be the last week of August, August 25th through August 30th. We are doing the Riviera Maya itinerary, which takes us to Cozumel, which we were just talking about, Cozumel/Playa del Carmen, and the beach club at Bimini, which we were also just talking about. It is a wonderful five-night cruise on the Valiant Lady, perfect for a weekend, or not a weekend, a perfect getaway for all the ladies in your life. We get together, we have good fun. Lots of camaraderie and lots of fun and fellowship. All my sassy ladies, there's still quite a few of you are in the chat. They can attest to a very, very, very good time. It's going to be a lot of fun. Right now, you got till April 27th is final payment. Mm-hmm. So if you're trying to do like a portion now and a portion later, that's what the final payment deadline is. If you can still book after after the 27th of April, it'll just be full payment due at that time. Virgin does really good with cancellation policies. So if you do have anything come up where you need to change your sail date or move something around, they're very easy with that. But the thing with Virgin is that you are getting scroll. Other way. Down. There. Why Virgin? You get all this stuff included. You get your food included. You got over 20 restaurants and eateries on board. You get your Wi-Fi is included. Your gratuities are included. You get shows which are epic and like some of the best production shows that we have seen on any cruise line. You get your essential drinks for free, so that your sodas, your basic coffee, basic juices, and those kind of things for free. Plus you get water in your room, that's bubbly water and regular water, and a little carafe in your room. Plus you get group workouts. Those are a cost on any other cruise line, and you get to pick group workouts for free. All that's included. So what Terry was about to say was that the special that they are doing right now, where you get some free bar bonus bar tab, that is running out, y'all. So and what is it? The 31st?
Yeah, the bar tab goes away.
They're not doing any free bar tab anymore. So if you are trying to get free bar tab, that is basically just free money to drink with.
You got to the end of this month to book.
Not to sail, but to book. And that's for any Virgin voyage from here for till the next 2 years or any time that they're sailing. So book now if you want the free bar tap.
Yeah.
So we got Sisterhood coming up in August, and then we have Sisterhood 25.
Well, before that, we have...
Oh my God.
For couples only cruise.
Because this one we put together so quickly.
January 2025.
This one, I'm really, really excited about, y'all. Because we're going to Colombia. How many of you have ever wanted to go to South America and go to Colombia? This is your chance to go. It is our longest cruise that we have ever put together. It's an 11-night cruise going to Colombia and the Southern Caribbean. We'll be visiting Curaçao, Aruba, St. Lucia, Antigua and Barbuda, and St. Martin. If you've never been to St. Martin, you see that picture there. I'm pointing the wrong way. The picture there with the airplane flying over the beach. That is Maho Beach. That is where that happens. The airplanes really do fly that close to you. It is absolutely beautiful there. And plus, we get extended times in ports, literally all day in Colombia.
From 8 a.m. to midnight.
Literally all day in Aruba. So you can't beat that.
Yeah, It's gonna be a blast. And if you know us, we've already I've already acquired an Addy and Terry soiree for Cartagena. And of course Aruba, we just may have to do another takeover. We're gonna
lock it down.
As well as some other places. And we're gonna add some foodie things some foodie in there things. As well. So yes. Not just cocktails. If so you y'all love get good to food, see we're gonna Addy surprise Chef. You on this this upcoming cruise. But you'll be able to find all those and so many more on our website at addyandterry.com, Sisterhood at C24, the ANT Mexico City land-based tour, Melanin at C3, AT Four Couples Only, the MSC World America after she makes her debut here in the country.
Yes, we still gonna cruise MSC.
Sisterhood at Sea, going to Greece in 2025. That is the next Virgin cruise. You want to go ahead and tell them that since we're talking about Virgin.
Okay, so the next Sisterhood at Sea will be next year, June 8th through June 15th. It is a week doing the Greek Island Glow itinerary, visiting all the wonderful ports in Greece. We're gonna do some I think it's an overnight in Mykonos. And then we also have Santorini, and we got Rhodes. It starts in Athens, so you get to get all your wonderful history stuff in there. I have some excellent, excellent, excellent excursions planned. You do not want to miss.
Oh, no.
And if you saw our Instagram stories when we went for Terry's birthday, that should give you a little bit of a teaser as to what
the series is coming out, because people are getting ready to go to the Med, so we're gonna be putting that here real soon.
So that was a teaser as to what we will be doing, so you'll be able to see it once we get those videos up. And you really, really, really want to book this one. It's like you don't want to miss this one. It is a bucket list item for sure. Definitely.
It's gonna be a good time, man.
Lots of
and
fun.
And if you want that free bar tab and all the good stuff, and you wanted that extra Addy and Terry sailor loot, please book before
the 31st.
Or put your deposit down.
At least that's all you got to do is deposit.
Before the end of this month.
Mm-hmm.
Just like that.
Boom. Yes.
Did I go over everything?
So excited. And then
Update on Havana. Of course, if you've been watching the news, then you know that there are some things going on in Cuba at the moment. So we're waiting to hear back from our advisor and the government on that. We'll let you guys know.
You know as soon as we hear back from our people.
Maybe a revolution going on in Cuba.
I don't.
They need it.
It's like, I hope, but no, because I want to visit. So. Yeah.
And then, of course, the Norwegian Aqua when it makes its debut on next year as well. So those are just some of the upcoming trips that we have and how you can be a part as you get out on these seas and sail with us.
And Brotherhood at Sea is coming back.
Yep.
We just don't know when yet. He's investigating.
Yeah, that way.
So. There's that.
Anna Q says, going back to the cocktail, you have to tell them the exact ingredients, I guess. Yeah, just, you know, just bourbon, sugar, bitters.
Literally tell them that.
Or just tell them no fruit.
Yeah, that's what he usually tells them. If he sees them getting ready, if he sees them grab the muddler, he gets their attention really quickly and says, no fruit, no fruit.
Yeah.
And then they're like, okay.
Coco's like digging up the backyard here.
Again?
Yeah.
Because he's doing that. Toddler thing.
Q says, so will the sugar balance out the bitters in the old fashioned? Yes.
It's not bitter though.
But yeah, the bitters aren't really bitter. It has kind of like an aromatic kind of flavor profile to it. Next time you're at a bar, I know it's kind of a weird request, but ask the bartender if it's okay for you to taste a bitter. Have them put it like on like a little spoon or something and try it so you can kind of see what they taste like and experiment with them, because there's different types of bitters, just like there's different types of spices. Let's see. Taryn says, at Gina's World, I've used it and enjoyed it expedited through the lines and food beverage in the lounge. That's going back to Mobay in Jamaica. Teresa T says, alchemy has never done me wrong, so I just stuck with lavender lemon drops for the rest of the night. Janelle says, oh, this banana between the sheets is good. It seems cognac poured.
Yes.
Gina's World says, thanks, Taryn. Mile High Melanin says, if you're going to have fruit with whiskey, might as well get a Manhattan. Yeah, and a Manhattan is no fruit either. That's just cherry
just juice,
on top.
Yeah.
Teresa T says, the recipe's on the website. Gina says, lavender lemon drops? Shout out to LK Family Travel. Teresa T says, yes.
Welcome, guys.
They felt so bad and wanted to make me something else. She asked if I'd liked lemon drops. I was like, yeah, but could you add lavender? I had the whole bar ordering them. They were that good.
That does sound good.
Janelle T says she's going with her little sisters. Brother Mallard Sassy. Says, sipping on a Long Island iced tea. D Naturally 23 says, question, will Virgin be getting rid of the MNVV deal as well or just the bar tab?
Oh, no, no, no. It's just the bar tab. MNVV is here to stay. That's, And I do have some for sale if you guys want, or not I, but we have some for sale if you guys want to purchase the MNVV. It is basically, the MNVV stands for My Next Virgin Voyage. It is basically put $300 down. And the one that we have is for $300. You get that $300. You pay $300 and you get that $300 toward your, it gives you $300 of sailor loot. So you're basically putting $300 down toward your deposit because it doesn't cover the full deposit because deposit is 20%. But it goes toward your deposit and that $300 is also sailor loot in your pocket.
Boom, that way.
If you want to take advantage of that, just give us a, just send us an email and say MNVV, and I'll know exactly what you're talking about.
Boom. Anna Q says that overnight in Mykonos going to be fire.
It was so much fun, you guys. When I say Mykonos is a party town, day and night.
Yeah, that way.
Naps are necessary.
A marvelous, accessible life. Welcome to the Sunday Sip.
Welcome. Glad
to have you here. That sounds like a very new name. Says, hi, Addy and Terry. I want to thank you for the advice you gave me years ago regarding starting a channel. I didn't start then. Life happened, but my husband and I finally started it. This is it. Many thanks. Congratulations.
Oh,
and we will definitely be checking you out.
That is so awesome. So happy for you.
Cam Lynn for the win says, sounds exciting. And a Q says, viva la Cuba Libre.
Cuba Libre.
Melba Sampson says, what do you guys think of the fires that happened on the Carnival Freedom? We talked about this earlier. Should I be scared to sail? Not at all.
They're going to take really good care of all the guests on board.
Yeah,
so,
no worries there. No.
We like to joke about Carnival, but there's absolutely nothing wrong with the ship. The fire did not start because of something wrong with the ship.
No.
It got hit by lightning, and because it is still it was still such a brand new funnel. They just got it replaced 5 months ago. It caught fire.
Yeah.
So
I bet they were like,
dang.
Anna Q says, when do your MNVV certificates expire?
They do not. You get up to, well, I won't say it that way. If you purchase them on board, you have 60 days to get $600 toward your cruise. So if you purchase it on board, instead of the $300 of sailor loot or bar tab, whichever one you happen to get when you're on board, it's usually sailor loot though. Within 60 days, they give you double. So if you put down 300, they're giving you 600 if you use it within the 60 days. If you use it after the 60 days, but before 2 years, you get $300. So you have a 2 year span on when you purchase. So from the date that you purchase till 2 years later, that's your window of time. And that is just to book.
Yeah.
You don't have to sail within those 2 years. So if you want to call in day on the night before your three or your night before your 2 years is up and book, you can certainly book for another year later. Uh-huh. You don't want to give me another cherry?
My bad, man.
You don't want to give me no cherries. I know where you keep
them. I got like three left. You gonna buy me another thing?
I will buy another jar.
Okay. All right, man. Let's get back to some more cruise news. A couple of other things took place, of course, this week.
Uh-huh.
Where did my thing go? There it is. All right. First off, why is that not working? Uh-oh. My mouse is like all over the place.
Oh, wow.
I am definitely going to have to get my computer fixed because I cannot. My scrolling just completely stopped. There we go. All right. So for those of you that are going to be taking a Royal or are going to be taking a Royal Caribbean cruise, and your stop did consist of Labadee, Haiti, They are going to be taking a pause on that port for at least a month.
Oh, wow.
Due to all the stuff that's going on in that country, civil which is so, unrest. So unfortunate. But if you had a port of call to Labadee, Haiti, they are going to be rescheduling you to another port of call. So they have pulled all those itineraries from their entire fleet.
Oh, wow.
For at least a month. It could be longer, but right now. So if you've had shore excursions and stuff like that, they have, especially if they require you to leave the compound, those have been canceled. And they have suspended all of those sailings. I think some that were impacted were the Explorer of the Seas five-night cruise from Miami departing on the 31st, for example, will now call on Grand Cayman, while the ship's April 14th departure will visit Perfect Day at Coco Cay in place of Labadee. The Oasis of the Seas March 31st departure from Miami on a seven-night I was going to visit Perfect Day at Coco Cay, but will now spend 2 days at the private destination.
Oh, wow. Two days at Perfect Day instead of a Perfect Day in Labadee.
Yeah, so there you go. New cruise news for new ships, and it's good to see this cruise line getting into the game because they've only had about four ships for last couple of years, but they've been killing you in the pocketbook. Disney Cruise Line announced the third of its Wish class ship.
We haven't even done the first Wish.
I know. We got to get on that bad boy. And it's going to be called the Disney Destiny.
That's cute.
It is currently under construction at Meyer Werft in Germany, and it is due to set sail in 2025.
That's right, because Treasure is supposed to come out soon.
End of this year.
Yeah.
I didn't even know they were working on another ship outside of...
I knew. Yeah, they're supposed to do three wish class.
Yeah. They are, they're going to have a Hero Mini on the back of the ship. A Hero Mini on the bow in a superhero style stance. And they're saying that this new ship will sport... right. will sport a heroes and villains design theme. So
okay.
That is intriguing.
I think that is going to be so much fun.
So with heroes and villains, do you think it's going to take a strong lean toward Marvel?
I hope so. I really do.
And the Marvel universe on this particular one?
I really, really hope so because that's what I
Yeah, would personally be into.
I personally would be either Marvel or even like some of the Pixar stuff.
Yeah.
You could do some crazy villains with the Pixar stuff.
Oh, you sure could. They say that some of the elements are going to focus on Disney's legendary characters, popular villains, and beloved heroes. So, you know, you got some villains in the old school world, too. Marvel characters will be featured on the ship, too, along with other Disney favorites from The Lion King, Hercules, and 101 Dalmatians.
I don't think we've seen anything with Hercules before.
No. Nah.
That'd be awesome.
It's said to be a 4,000-guest ship.
Mm-hmm.
And
that's pretty big.
It's set to begin sailing in spring of 2025.
That's pretty big.
No delivery date as of right now.
I'm excited. When are we going to do the wish, babe?
We need to do it soon.
Because we have yet to do
it. And if you have sailed out of the port of Miami recently, then you have seen the behemoth of a cruise port that MSC has been building.
It's monstrous.
They were in the news pretty heavy because of the Ben and David debacle, but they are still doing things, and they have now announced that they're going to be doing the christening ceremony.
Mm-hmm. For your America.
For the world America.
I was about to say Europa.
Which debuts in not the spring Europa. Of next year, right there at the brand new port. Now, World America has a guest capacity of about 6,700 people.
That is a ginormous ship.
And it'll be doing both Eastern and Western Caribbean sailings. Now, when we were on the Icon and we were going by the port, I was like, is this thing going to end?
Still going. It's huge.
It's huge. But they're saying it should be able to accommodate two world-class ships at the same time. So if that tells you anything, so if you can imagine
12,000 people,
two icons
back to back
at the same time, that's kind of what they're going for.
That is so many
The naming
people.
Ceremony is set for April 9th.
Yes.
And it'll be held at the new terminal port with live music, VIP speeches, previews of the onboard entertainment, a short preview cruise for trade partners and media. Will take place after the NAMI event. Hey, maybe we'll get in.
Maybe we'll get invited.
The maiden voyage will depart from Miami on April 12th of next year. The 7-night Eastern Caribbean sailing will visit the Dominican Republic, Puerto Rico, and MSC's Ocean Key Marine Reserve.
Yes, because our group cruise is not on the maiden voyage, but the one that is a week or two later.
Yeah, a week or two later. Mm-hmm. They're saying that it will be the world's largest cruise terminal. Mm-hmm. They will be able to accommodate 36,000 people per day.
Because they not only want the two world-class ships to be
they
there.
They want the regular-sized ships
to be there as well as that. Ooh. So they're expecting. This is how we know MSC says, we here to stay.
Yeah.
They are expecting to do big things in the U.S. But the thing I want to know is, are they still going to have Sophia Loren be the grandmother?
Bruh.
Talk about somebody that needs to retire.
Bruh, like, they gonna give her, like, I was about to go there. And
I don't want to be mean. I love Sophia.
I was like,
she is a beautiful soul.
Sophia must have put it down on somebody in the family back in the day, because she is the godmother of every single
she
ship.
She is
they
the
got.
Singular godmother for MSC. Bruh. But my thing is, she's so old now. And I'm nothing against her being old, and nothing against, because she's a beautiful woman. She's still doing her thing. But
Sophia got that.
But she, but because it's a U.S. based ship now, it's going to be specifically World America. That's my question: is are they going to choose a different godmother? That's the question. But Sophia, you said Sophia put it down.
She put it down on somebody. They said, you know what? You could be the godmother.
You godmother for life. Godmother for life.
Godmother for life. All right. Back to the comments, and then we're going to get ready to get up out of here, man. Let you guys enjoy the rest of your Sunday. Shout out to Brian Martin. Good afternoon to you as well as Stay With Kay. Welcome to the Sunday Sip. You sound pretty new. Glad to have you here. A Marvelous Accessible Life says, thank you so much to give you a timeline of when you gave me the advice. It was when you guys were deciding to do the live Sunday Sip.
Oh, wow.
Welcome to this creator life. I hope you're ready.
Desiree that is Dixon crazy.
Says, does Virgin Voyages sail out of any California port round trip?
No. Very right simple now. Answer, no.
Not right now. Maybe somewhere in the distant future.
Maybe in the future, but not at the time being, because they only got technically three ships.
Yeah.
And they are still undecided as the fourth ship.
Of which all three of their ships will be sailing in
the Caribbean
at the same time this year.
Yes.
You believe that? Melanie Ashford says, we've been on the Disney Wish and loved it so. Putting my coins together now to sail on the Destiny.
Yeah. Okay, so if we don't do the Wish, we got to try the Treasure.
Right.
But I'm thinking the Wish might be better for us because it's got the Star Wars-y stuff on it.
Yeah. I mean, we just need to do the Wish anyway. We've only done
We've only done the Fantasy.
We've only done one Disney.
So cruise. We need to do another just because we need to expand our Disney.
Yeah. We would love to go and try Disney again from a couple's grown and
grown and sexy vibe.
And empty nesting way, you know.
Like we did the first one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's see. KB says, yes, Marvel ship, yes, Wakanda forever. Can you imagine that on there? Like, can you, man, like I'm starting to daydream.
put Black Panther on the back. Put Minnie, or no, it would be cuter with like Donald. Put Donald in the Black Panther costume.
No, can you imagine?
On the back of the ship.
Carla G says, Sophia Loren is 89.
Oh, man. She out here doing things.
Melba Sampson says, MSC not only said we're here to stay, but also we ain't playing with y'all.
We ain't playing with y'all. We coming to the U.S.
Your mom said, yes, she is. Janelle T says, Lady Eloise.
Yes.
Let's see here, man. Good Palm Sunday, everybody. Yo, like, this has been pretty cool.
Terry babysat that drink,
y'all. Kind of hanging, man. That thing is so good. I wasn't ready for it to go until I could make another one, but yeah.
He babysat it because it is so good.
Let's see. Anything else we got to cover before we get out of here? Last chance for questions. We're going to hang out.
Maybe 5 more minutes.
Yeah.
And then,
if you got any questions, now
then we going to go cook dinner. Find a movie.
To ask. Did you see Holland America is going to have like their own like spices?
What?
Called with the Spice House. They've teamed up and they're going to be selling spices on board and feature 4 of their blends. That's different.
Okay.
Say that the recipes will be like an Alaska salmon rub, which is like citrus Alaskan salmon and pearled saffron couscous grain bowl.
That actually sounds really delicious.
Dutch table, home-cured grilled steak and garlic mashed potatoes.
That's
the Far East.
Delicious.
Holland America Far East shrimp biryani.
Biryani, yeah. Ooh.
And legendary Mediterranean herb, marinated cauliflower steak and chimichurri sauce.
I would like, no, I wouldn't. I don't like cauliflower like that, but you do. But you can't eat chimichurri because of the cilantro.
So, yeah. I mean, a lot of
but people I love curry.
Get into a lot of different things, man.
Yeah. Isn't Holland America the line that Oprah did a thing with?
Mm-hmm.
She did her cruise on Holland.
That's right. She was a part of that at one point.
Yeah.
Before we get out of here, I completely forgot. So Virgin is doing what they call the summer season pass, which will allow you to sail for basically 4 back-to-backs.
This is awesome, y'all.
4 months. So if you can imagine taking a 30-day cruise on the Scarlet Lady in the entire Mediterranean for $10,000 for the cabin.
For
roughly
2
people. They're going to give you some of the...
The
Rockstar perks
plus the deep...
Some of the deep blue perks, of the Splash Romance perks. Huge.
It's a great deal.
If you've been wondering, they're not just going to do Scarlet. As a matter of fact, I just got information that due to increasing demand, they are now extending their summer season pass to... The Resilient Lady.
What?
Coming out of Athens, giving more people the chance to work from the helm this summer. Those new passes available on the Resilient are now, if you want to sail for 30 days in June, it is June 2nd through June 30th. The July option, the first option, is June 30th through July 28th. And the second option is July 7th through August 4th. Prices starting again from $9,990 for up to 2 guests.
Y'all, that is such a good deal. Because you can't even cruise 4 back-to-back cruises for less than that.
Nah, think about that. Some cruises you're going to do for 7 days and you could, depending on the cabin, you get paid $10,000. But you're taking
two people,
everything included. Doing
plus perks
the entire Mediterranean,
and they're all different itineraries each week, so it's not like going back to back.
Already threw that at my boss,
and he said it was okay.
I was like, yo, how would you feel if I work from?
So if y'all see an extended sip from the ship,
right? They're gonna get up one Sunday and they're gonna be like, yo, are they sipping today? And we'll be like,
we deaf. Sipping from
Bonja,
the ship.
Baby.
Bonjour. Y'all. Yeah, I don't think y'all understand the awesomeness of this deal.
Like, world cruises are cool, but think about it. I mean, you're going to pay, on some Disney cruises, you're going to pay more than $10,000.
For 2 people.
For 3 days.
Right. This is a month.
Virgin is going to give you a central sea terrace, premium Wi-Fi, laundry service, early access booking, priority and priority disembarkation. They're going to give you access to Richard's rooftop, $10 coffee credit per cabin. And
that $10 coffee credit is one of the best perks of the deep blue perks.
Oh, these itineraries you got. All right. So just to give you, and you can kind of go do the research
on your own, but still
for Scarlet in June, week 1, consists of French Days and Ibiza Nights, the Irresistible Med in Rome. Mm. Then you come back and repeat the French Days and Ibiza Nights, and then you just do the Irresistible Med.
Babe.
So you get two nights
just talking about Ibiza. We were just talking about
two overnight stays in Ibiza that month.
We were literally just talking about Ibiza, looking at the lineups at the clubs.
Hey man, did you think I was
in 2 weeks?
But I would now that it's an option, I would probably jump on Resilient, because Resilient, just to give you an example, week one is their Greek Island Glow itinerary, which we did for my birthday last year.
Right.
Week two is also Greek Island Glow, so they're going to flip it in reverse.
You're doing back to back.
Then week three is the Adriatic Sea and Greek gym.
So you get to go up to see like Croatia and then
they come back with the Greek Island Glow again. So if you could imagine.
Greek Island Glow is such a great itinerary, y'all.
Three overnights in Mykonos. That month. Three overnights in Mykonos. Plus, you're going to go to Santorini three times. You're going to go to Bodrum. You're going to go to Rhodes.
Athens. The food is going to be epic.
Yeah, so if you are
so good in Greece.
If you are one of those people that can work remotely. And
plus, they're giving you the premium Wi-Fi.
Are looking for an amazing, amazing summer. Then you know what to do. Scan that QR code,
y'all.
Because you never know. You might see us out and about on the seas. And speaking of Virgin Voyages, shout out to Where in the World is CL?
If y'all don't know. Oh, my God.
If you have not seen her channel. If you have not seen her beautiful self on board Virgin.
She is such a sweetie.
She is like the ambassador of ambassadors. Just an overall great person. Glad to see you stopping through the Sunday sip.
And her Instagram, if y'all got any questions on taking your drone, she is like an epic drone photographer, y'all.
Yeah, man.
So all those cute little drone selfies, she will show you how to do them. So, hey, Christine.
What's up? Like, can I add her to like my YouTube crush list?
I guess.
All right, I could do that. All right. I'm tripping, man. Sydney says, Rita Marino, 92. Shout out to CL. Great having you hanging out with us. But
yes, Rita Marino is gorgeous.
Virgin is just that deal. Brian Martin says, question, do y'all plan on sailing on the new Sun Princess anytime this year?
This year? I don't know. I don't know if we got time. I mean, we kind of do, but we kind of don't. So,
y'all gotta realize we pay for all these trips.
Right. I'm like, but.
Well, y'all be asking, y'all gonna do this?
I mean,
this
we would need
like,
to see way more super chats. We would need to see way more super chats.
I just had like a fire sale on like but, so much camera and equipment just to be able to pay for the stuff we got this year. So
for the Sun Princess.
I can start selling my borrow.
Is. No, we can't. The Sun Princess is gorgeous. And we do want to sail her. It just may not be this year.
Yeah. But
if there's some princess peeps out there.
Yeah, because I saw that they invited quite a few people to come and check it out. But
none that...
So, with that being said.
Yeah, so...
Cindy says, have a great week, everyone. I'm listening, but starting dinner myself.
Yeah, we got to start dinner.
Walter Saunders says, do you think Margaritaville at Sea will buy Costa Magica and dock in San Diego year-round, do their hotel there as well?
That is a good suggestion.
Cheryl says, great Sunday sip. Enjoy y'all's Easter Sunday.
Thank you.
Denaturally23 says, speaking of perks, any news on Virgin's loyalty program? I thought they were updating it to not only status match.
They are. It is actually, I spoke to our, is his title? Development director, our business person for Virgin. And he says that they are still working out all the details, is not ready for us to release out to the public yet, but they are still working out all the details for the sailing club is what they're calling the Virgin, loyalty club.
I didn't realize they were going back to that.
Yeah, no, they're not doing status match anymore.
But no, that's gone.
But they're called the loyalty club is going to be called the sailing club.
Oh,
so, okay. So stay tuned. They just haven't released any of the information yet for us to have it. We literally just had this conversation like a week ago.
That's true.
So, they were supposed to release it, but they're still working out the kinks.
Let's see. Deja Marie says, I'm tempted to do the month, but plane tickets are about 8,000 plus for two people.
Oh, I ain't even look at that. No.
I need to see how Turkish Oops. Airlines is operating at the
I ain't
moment.
Even look at the flights. I was just like, oh, that's a good deal.
Yeah, man.
But yeah, I ain't even look at the flights.
Teresa T says, I agree. Love that coffee
that
credit.
That coffee credit is because they, I swear, Virgin has the best flat white coffee at sea. It is the best I've ever had.
Where in the world is CL says, what's up to this amazing couple right back at you.
She
saying
is
you guys
so
are the
sweet.
Best.
Love
Keisa
you.
Keisa says, I love her channel.
Oh, there you go. Mark, and if you're not watching, you'll go sign up, go subscribe like right now.
Right now. Right. Mario says, Margaritaville at Sea will be doing cruises in 2025 up to 7 nights. That mm-hmm. doesn't sound very exciting to me.
Uh-oh.
I actually had some
it's
news.
It's on the new new. Well, the old
news. No, I had some news about Margaritaville. At sea.
No, I'm saying the.
I think it's on my notes upstairs.
The newer ship will be doing the longer sailings.
Yeah. Let's see. Angela says Christine is the real deal. Met her at TravelCon a few years ago.
Oh, we love that you guys know her.
Camlin, have a yes. good evening and a great Holy Week to you as well. Carla says, when are you thinking about going? There's a cool concert in May. I might go. Felicia says, have a blessed week. And Cheryl says, Addy, you are right. I noticed the same thing about the Sun Princess invitees. Hmm. Naomi says, when do you think we can book flights for Greece? It's not showing flights for June 2025.
I would say wait till at least the 6-month mark.
Yeah.
Because they're not going to have anything like concrete until at least then.
Yeah. That's the only unfortunate part about traveling over there. Way out because mm-hmm. you gotta wait until they post.
So I would say by the end of this year, start looking at prices for Sisterhood 25.
Shout out to Charlie's World in the house.
Hello.
And just like that, we have gotten to the end of our chat. 3 minutes to spare. CL's channel got her ready for 2.5. Shout out to Gina's World. It is time for us to make our way out of here. I'm gonna go out and have a cigar on the porch and enjoy the rest of this beautiful, beautiful Palm Sunday. So if this is your
wrong one.
I know, I just clicked it. There we go.
There we go.
All right.
My chair keep rotating.
See, that's why I told you we need
to fix my chair.
Yeah. All right. So if you are, you know what to do, man. Take us out of here.
You always do the exit. I don't know what to say. Yes. I do the intro, you do the exit.
Oh. If you're watching the replay, man, first off, we're glad you sat through all of this to get to the end. We really appreciate you.
Thank you so much.
We have had an amazing time. Don't forget, if you want to travel the world like us or see some of the amazing ports of call and cruises that we are doing, you can find those on our website at addyandaddyandterry.com. Some major announcements coming in the latter half of Q2 as we transition into Q3.
You went way professional.
Yeah.
Q2s and threes.
First half and middle half of the year.
Spring and summer, y'all. Spring and summer.
Yeah, that way. That's why I told you to do it.
Okay.
Anywho, big stuff coming.
Big stuff coming.
Big things for us coming. Hopefully you guys have an amazing week. We will probably not sip on next Sunday. That way you can enjoy your Easter Sunday with
and if
your
you got
family.
Babies and grandbabies, do an Easter egg hunt.
All that.
Those are always fun.
Yeah.
Send me some chocolate.
Yeah. Man, y'all have a great week. We love y'all.
Love y'all.
We gone.